Hello again, everyone, and welcome back to the Truckin' Journey. I am Trucker Jim, and this is episode 3. It is Sunday again here in Little Rock. I am chilling in the Galloway waiting on a pizza to come that I purchased with my little card that Maverick gave me the first day I got here that had $50 on it, and I still had about 20 bucks. So I said, hey, it's pizza time. Because also tomorrow is Monday, so there's another orientation class doing their DOT physical, and what that means is no breakfast. So I thought I'd have a little leftover pizza so I could have some breakfast in the morning. So while I'm waiting on the pizza delivery person to knock upon my door and bring me some pizza and wings, I thought I would take a moment to share just a little bit of footage of Securement Training Redo, which has been much, much easier for me this time. I actually feel smart now, and I'm able to help other people out, and I get it. Last week, first few days anyway, I did not have that same emotion. Well, now I know why everything is so clean in the Securement area. It is what's today, Wednesday? And our group is going through cleaning everything, losing all the ratchet binders and the open binders, sweeping all the floors, making sure all the equipment is where it's supposed to be to get ready for the next group that's finishing up orientation and starting Securement training today, which I'll be with them. Well, that part's done. If I wasn't doing Securement training again, I would be packing up, getting ready to get set up with a trainer for a week or two. But instead, it's deja vu all over again.
Right,
Hey guys, now last week when I experienced this and got hired on officially by Maverick, I missed the shot because I didn't know this was coming. But something Maverick does that's very, very cool is all of the trainers and, you know, more experienced guys and office staff is going to be lined up here. And when all these new guys come out of this door, they're going to be lined up and they're shaking hands, giving high fives, saying, welcome to Maverick, welcome to Maverick. Very, very cool. But this week, I'm going to get the shot and show it to you guys. See, everyone's lining up. This is when they do their class adventure.
That's what we need.
Now, you normally can't tell this when the fan is moving, but that is a big ass fan. Let's take a look at a few fields, people. This is high to the sky right here. All contacts are precisely buried. Our reward for such a tight build is we get to take it down. Yeah, I just finished my coil test, and not only am I the first to finish, but it is absolutely impossible for anyone to get more right answers than I got. You ask why? You know why. Because I got them all right.
And that's all right.
So that's just a little bit of an inside look of some of the things that happen at Maverick Orientation and also Securement Training. Safety is a big deal, and the instructors spend a lot of time making sure we know the proper way to get on a trailer, to get off a trailer, when you're setting up, you know, all the equipment that you need for your builds, place it on the trailer and then climb up, and your binders, you know, from do as much as you can from the ground. Because there is a saying here at Maverick, and that saying is, you don't want to make the slideshow. And people, trust me, you don't want to make the slideshow. Here's what I mean.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, bungee's coming all different coils. They got the straps like we have.
Oh,
yeah. Improper step two.
See what I mean? You don't want to make the slideshow. And these weren't just pictures like pulled off the internet to prove a point. These happened at Maverick. These were Maverick truck drivers. And I didn't even show the one of the ankle that looks sort of like a peanut butter and jelly sandwich, minus the peanut butter. Strawberry jelly, like, it's, I wasn't gonna show it. If I don't stop eating, I'm not gonna have leftovers for breakfast. Today is not just any old day here in Little Rock. Today is the day I do my final eval. Which after passing final eval, I can move to the next phase of my career. Which I could take that in one of two directions. I could get set up with a trainer and spend a week or until the trainer and I both agree that I'm ready to go on my own. Or I could just go on my own. All right. Final eval is over. Guess we'll find our grades after lunch.
I gotta give you all the bad news.
Wow.
Oh, it's the other way around, isn't it? I've got good news. We have everybody passed but two. And so
you killing us right now.
Come
I
on,
you.
I know.
Your man, you knew you did.
I'm dying.
Yeah.
Is it Tawan?
Yeah.
Tawan. Stand up, Tawan. See this guy right here? The only guy in the class made a 100. Give him a hand.
Oh,
hang on, please, because you got to pass it back in, because we all going to be scanned in the computer. That's what I'm saying.
All right. Fine, get a perfect score.
Right. Yeah. Kyle Tracy, he's back there. I'll be right back.
Good news and bad news. I passed, so I move on to the next phase, but I did not get a perfect score, so maybe I need to go out with a trainer. Well, it is getting close to bedtime here in Little Rock, Arkansas, because I tell you guys, 4:30 in the morning comes pretty early. But Securement Training is coming to a close. Tomorrow is another cool day. But you guys are just going to have to tune into episode 4 to see what happens. But just to give you a little hint, we're going to be working on tarping tomorrow, which is a pretty big deal because Maverick is known for their beautiful tarping jobs. And you'll be seeing some in future episodes. And also, we're going to find out who our trainer is tomorrow. I had thought about not going with the trainer because I know how to drive a truck. I don't need a guy to teach me that or how to back up or really deal with shippers and everything. But the securement side of things, you definitely want to be solid at. And for myself, I have yet to gain any real world flatbed experience. you know, only in the Securement training area, which is great, but in there, you know, it's a controlled environment and there's no wind blowing and just big ass fans, and you know, we're securing small wooden light, you know, coils, not 45,000 pound steel coils. So, you know, there's a little bit of difference there. So I figured going out with a trainer would be a wise investment of my time. Now for new drivers, it's a minimum of 21 days out on the road with a trainer. And they will keep you as long as needed till both of you agree that you're ready to go out on your own. For us experienced drivers, there is no minimum. I'm thinking in my mind, hey, a week would be good. But, you know, that is not 100% up to me. But guys, thanks a lot for watching. But it's time to wrap up this week's episode. But starting in episode 4, I'm expecting you will see somewhere besides Little Rock, Arkansas. Because I'll be out on the road again. Going God knows where. Because I'm in the USA division of Maverick's flatbed. Which means I can go anywhere in America. But there's also quite a few regions of Maverick. There's lots of positions where you'll be home every weekend. There's even ones where you can be home every day. And off on the weekend, there's a temperature control if, I don't know, flatbed just isn't your thing. Because it is a challenge, guys. But that's why I'm here. And there's even a glass division. We call those guys the glass holes. Hey, but if you'd like to find out any information, if you're in Maverick's hiring area, in the description box of this video, I'm going to have a link to an online application and also the number for the recruiting department. But make sure you come back and see episode 4 and beyond. But everyone, be safe out there and keep on trucking.